The National Budget Framework paper shows the summary of expected income and expenditure of a country at a specific period of time. According to the Public Finance Management Act of 2015, government is mandated to lay the budget framework paper before Parliament for consideration before the 31st of December. Today, the Ministry of Finance was able to beat the deadline with a 43 trillion budget framework paper for the financial year 2022-2023.
I beg to lay the National Budget Framework paper for financial year 2022-2023-2026-2027. I beg to lay. Right, Honourable Speaker.
Let the records capture that.
The Speaker of Parliament, Jacob Olanyata's committees of Parliament to scrutinize the 43 trillion framework paper immediately after Christmas recess.
While we break, they can still study it privately and then eventually start convening meetings on how to handle this matter, and of course eventually it will go to the budget committee and we find a way to move. As for the charter, we'll debate it. That will be the first thing when we come, but when we resume next year, it will be the first thing that we handle.
The budget framework paper lays mainly the outlook for the next financial year, 2022-2023, and the key issue, our theme is mainly on how can we improve wealth among the people.
However, the Leader of Opposition, Mathias Mpuuga Nsamba, raised a procedural matter and noted that it would be illegal for Parliament to receive and approve the budget framework paper without debating and approving the Charter of Fiscal Responsibility that was presented last week.
Honourable Speaker, this is not an attempt to necessarily block the minister from laying, but we want to get the way of our methods of work very clearly. What does the law say? The charter to be debated, approved, and published within 1 week by the minister. And none of these has been done. The leader of the opposition, the charter should be discussed and approved by Parliament. The budget framework paper must be discussed and approved by Parliament and recommendations made to the President by the 15th of February.
Legislators have vowed to ensure that the next financial year budget prioritizes education, health sector and economic recovery before it's adopted.
Where emphasis will be put, one is to cut in areas that have a lot of money but are not very vital and important to our economic recovery and development, so that we put the money in the area of education and the area of agriculture, because these two sectors are very, very important. The knowledge of any country determines to its growth.
All our expenditures should be gearing towards economic recovery, not creating new cost centers, but economic recovery. And economic recovery means we should be, UDB should now be at play, giving stimulus packages. Government should be coming out to guide, because the other time when we gave money to UDB, UDB continued using money through the normal channel. And they say, no, this is not political money, this is not a stimulus package, it is a loan, it is a recapitalization.
Education, which has been badly hit by the COVID-19, that sector needs a lot of focus. We have health, which is limping with minimal, facilities,
Parliament has also adopted a supplementary expenditure of 21 billion shillings under Schedule No. 1 for financial year 2021-2022 to Uganda Land Commission to settle outstanding claims by the Church of Uganda.